Anyone who successfully transitioned from a top model to a top actor is special in a number of aspects. It's because models use only their appearances and their charms to non-verbally communicate with people, and when they use this ability and their inborn elegance in acting, they can create a new level of synergy. Today, we're gonna explore one of such actors. He is an actor who already had a successful modeling career but decided to jump into acting, and now stars in a worldwide famous online series. It's the one and only Joo Ji-hoon. Joo Ji-hoon is a 188.7cm tall model-turned-actor with a charming young noble man kind of face. As far as his appearance is concerned, he almost looks like he was born to be an actor. But did you know that Joo Ji-hoon has previously faced some negative prejudice because of the way he looks? The biggest example is his uneven eyes. When Joo Ji-hoon had just begun to transition from modeling to acting, many people told him, "You're gonna have a hard time making it as an actor because your eyes are uneven. You don't have a face for it." However, Joo Ji-hoon kept pursuing acting nonetheless, and now his uneven eyes are one of his most significant tools. His eyes, which can express both the good and evil, began to show their value in the television series The Devil in 2007. He played a lawyer named Oh Seung-ha, and with his face and his eyes, he beautifully expressed the double-sidedness of Oh Seung-ha, who always stood on the side of the marginalized with a warm smile on his face, while at the same time was planning a murder. Joo Ji-hoon's uneven eyes also played a major role in expressing his characters in the 2012 movie I Am the King, in which he played both Deok-chil, the drunken slave, and Grand Prince Chun-young. When it comes to acting, Joo Ji-hoon is known to be a perfectionist. That explains why he's always been working hard and trying to expand to different fields of acting. He first began modeling because he enjoyed expressing things. Then he had a desire to express even more, so he got into acting. And in 2006, he started pursuing acting as a career with the series Princess Hours. Because he'd had close to zero experience in acting, Joo Ji-hoon wasn't really recognized for his acting skills when he starred in Princess Hours. Instead, he rose to stardom around this time for his handsome look and the popularity of the series. Joo Ji-hoon became a star in no time, but he didn't settle for it. After The Devil aired in 2007, he started to get recognition for his acting skills, and his popularity went beyond the borders of Korea to Japan. In 2008, he continued to try new things and made his debut in movies with the movie Antique, which was a comedy movie that dealt with homosexuality. With this movie, Joo Ji-hoon was able to show his talents and potential as an actor with a strong presence, as opposed to a young, delicate heartthrob. But it seems that being in a television series wasn't enough for him to fully express his talents and potential. In the next year, Joo Ji-hoon starred in his first ever musical, Don Juan. He starred in the musical Sailing for Life in 2010 as well, and he's been continuing to get more popular and improve his acting skills ever since by starring in a variety of K-dramas and movies. As his filmography indicates, Joo Ji-hoon is an actor with a wide spectrum of roles, ranging from a cake shop owner to the head of the North Korea State Security Department, to a serial killer, to a crown prince, and even to a grim reaper. Also, he plays one of the main roles in Netflix's Korean zombie thriller series called Kingdom, which is hugely popular around the world. His emotional acting skills and his ability to pull off action scenes in the series have made him even more skilled of an actor. So then, what exactly did Joo Ji-hoon do to be able to play all these different roles so masterfully? As a matter of fact, Joo Ji-hoon was yelled at a lot when he had just debuted due to his lack of acting skills. One time, during the table read for the series The Devil, he had trouble nailing the characteristics of Oh Seung-ha, the character he was playing, and the director quietly said to Joo Ji-hoon, "If you play him like that at the filming set, I'll kill you." This made Joo Ji-hoon work even harder. In his car, he would listen to Nothing But Don't Love, which was one of the soundtracks of The Devil, in order not to lose the emotions of Oh Seung-ha. Despite his gruesome schedule that allowed only 2 hours of sleep, he would review his lines and his facial expressions in every scene with the director, and actively participated in the whole filming process. When Joo Ji-hoon played the role of Im Seung-jae in the movie The Treacherous, not only did he thoroughly analyze his character, he also received a special training for the sword fighting and the sword dancing scenes. Because his scenes made up over 90% of the movie, he trained harder than anyone else to really master the sword fighting and sword dancing, and he memorized where to move in what order. Sadly though, when he went to the filming set, they would change all the choreographies to create better scenes. In the end, many of the scenes were shot with experts replacing Ju Ji-hoon. About this, Ju Ji-hoon expressed his sadness in an interview, saying that the reason he trained so hard was because of all the subtle emotions and tiny details in every action. Ju Ji-hoon's attention to every little detail in everything he does shaped him into a better actor in every new project he partook in after the movie The Treacherous, and he got a lot of good reviews for his steadily improving performance. But even Ju Ji-hoon, who is famously hardworking, was so devastated at one time that he even considered giving up acting. It was when he worked for the movie The Spy Gone North. Ju Ji-hoon played Jung Mu-taek, head of the North Korea State Security Department, and had to create a visceral sense of tension as he keeps his eye on spy Park Seok-myung and constantly threatens him. Every line and every little movement of every actor meant something. It was almost as if the actors had to do hardcore stunt scenes, except they were all done verbally as opposed to physically. Those verbal stunt scenes created a certain nerve-wracking atmosphere, and the actors had to rack their brains trying to figure out how to tell the story without breaking the harmony of the actors and the anxious atmosphere. Later in an interview, Ju Ji-hoon confessed, "I legit thought I was gonna lose my mind. Because of that weird anxiety, I kept forgetting my lines even when I memorized them over and over and over. I thought my brain had gotten dumb because of too much drinking. There was this unexplainable anxiety there." He added that he even had to be careful about every little hand gesture and even the sound of his breath. He explained, "I wasn't like taken aback per se, but for some reason, I had a little buffering in my head and just couldn't spit out my lines. So I thought, should I quit acting? Have I really gotten this bad at acting? I thought really hard over this repeatedly. Every day was a day of devastation and despair." Ju Ji-hoon said that in other movies, when you build a solid foundation at the beginning, normally everything becomes easier. This movie, on the other hand, was excruciating from start to finish. Apparently, even his co-stars in the movie, who have been in the business for years, struggled big time. However, it wasn't only in vain. Thanks to his amazing performance in The Spy Gone North, Ju Ji-hoon won awards in a number of award shows, including the 6th BIFF Marie Claire Asia Star Awards and the 39th Blue Dragon Film Awards. However, the biggest reward was his sharpened ability to analyze characters and his matured acting skills. That said, Ju Ji-hoon is currently getting an explosive amount of love and positive reviews from viewers around the world, thanks to his performance in Netflix's series Kingdom. He plays Crown Prince Yi Chang, and he worked especially hard to show how the character grows from season 1 of this show to season 2, which was aired just recently. He said that instead of preparing for the character's growth by getting the emotions ready in advance, he pays more attention to the script and the character surrounding itself in the filming set. As for the many action scenes in season 2, Ju Ji-hoon thought hard about how Yi Chang would demonstrate his leadership while at the same time not being able to lead the people like a total pro since he is a crown prince and not a warrior. As you can see, Ju Ji-hoon always analyzes his character meticulously and expresses his character realistically according to the character's situation. Which brings up the question, what did his co-stars or directors he worked with think of him? Veteran actor Hwang Jung-min, who co-starred in The Spy Gone North, which drove Ju Ji-hoon insane, praised him by saying, "Ju Ji-hoon is a very smart actor. He portrays the core essence of his character Jung Mu-taek flawlessly. He is bright and has great analytical skills." Director Kim Tae-kyun of the movie Dark Figure of Crime, where Ju Ji-hoon played a serial killer, was blown away by Ju Ji-hoon's acting skills as well as his attitude towards acting. To perfectly transform to the character, Ju Ji-hoon actually shaved his head, mastered Busan dialect, and acted with no makeup on his face. The director said in an interview that Ju Ji-hoon first suggested that he wear no makeup, and thanks to that, his facial expressions were more clearly visible in the movie. Meanwhile, actress Bae Doona, who co-starred in Kingdom, praised Ju Ji-hoon for what a fantastic mood maker he was. She said, "Ju Ji-hoon is a really funny friend. He feels like a little brother to me. He's so mischievous at the filming set that I get nervous. But you see, he's really smart because that's how he raises the morale of our crew. I'm sometimes a bit hard on him without realizing it. But when I saw him at the press release, he looked dapper." Director Kim Sung-hoon of Kingdom Season 1 said, "When you meet him privately, Ji-hoon is really bright. And he's extremely quick. I wonder if he attends an academy for it or something. He's incredibly knowledgeable too. And he's very good at reading the room as well." Scriptwriter Kim Eun-hee of Kingdom Season 2 agreed, saying, Joo Ji-hoon is a smart actor. Not smart in an annoying way, but there have been many occasions where he showed a very deep understanding of the script. We talked candidly about the script, and I even said he'll be fine even if we change all of his lines as long as he understands the goal of every scene. He is an extremely smart actor. As you can tell from all these reviews, Joo Ji-hoon doesn't just focus on his part of each scene. Rather, he approaches acting with a wide vision and stays mindful of the teamwork with everyone else. Whether in a movie or a television series, regardless of where he works or who he works with, Joo Ji-hoon's professionalism that makes him work so well in harmony with others seems to be what made him who he is today. The actor who might look a bit cold-hearted at first glance, but whose actual heart is filled with hot passion. Hopefully, his performance will continue to shine with the whole world as his stage. Thanks so much for watching today's video. Please hit the like button and subscribe. And that's it for today's video. See ya!